cross high, you got the shield. You got the pass, you got the backhand, you got the inside pin. Alright? For the shift, for the thrust, you've got the shield, you've got the pass, and you've got the backhand. So keep in mind when you guys are doing this, if you go for the shield, you're not blocking it. Because of your footwork, you're actually sweeping it out, sweeping it inside, sweeping it outside, and then inside sweep to pin. Same with this, you're sweeping it from the shoulder, sweeping it from the outside, sweeping it backhand, and that's it. When you guys are doing this, one small detail is when you do the pass, try to make sure you tuck in your thumb. There's a few, one or two seminars in the past years, we got one guy who snapped his thumb. So that's why I have to emphasize it. Before, I just thought that, yeah, he's a martial artist, he'll know what to do. But I have to emphasize it, right, guys? So when you guys are doing the pass, don't do this. Right? In training, it's great because he's not actually having the intention and pressure to push forward. But later, when you start doing the application, he'll get overexcited sometimes, and a little bit pressure forward will actually snap your finger. So when you guys are doing this, make sure it's a palm strike towards the shoulder, not this. Yes, if you do that slowly, that's what people try to do this, because they're trying to absorb the attack. So your intention is to hit his face, but because his hand is on the way, push it down. And then you pin it down. Same thing with the pass thrust, it's not this. Alright guys, you're actually hitting it. So if I was to take it this way, I'm trying to make sure I'm hitting here, there. Right, this is my intention, but for training purposes, it's there. Alright guys, so every time you guys are doing this, don't think about passing, don't think about not hurting him. Your intention is to hit it, to assume that that's his face. When you're doing this, you're not deflecting the blade. You're actually visualizing, you're hitting his body, but he's standing in the way. Alright guys, make sense? So that's why your alignment, this and this, is the same. The alignment is the same. Okay, guys? So, that on the side, this way. So, we want to sequence the attacks correctly. And then, once we sequence the attack and counter attack, we'll learn how to catch the techniques from there. Alright, guys? So, just to make it as clear as possible, it goes for a thrust with intention. Push your shoulder forward, thrust. Same length like me, I'm punching him. And then, slash. That's it, right? So exaggerate, thrust, exaggerate the shoulder. He goes for thrust. So I need to make sure, the reason why he has to exaggerate is I want to be familiar with this posture. Whenever I see this posture and I cannot see his hands, I'm assuming it's a low slash or a thrust because I cannot see his hands. If now I'm assuming it's a downward strike or a horizontal slash. Make sense or not? So this is to be familiar with his posture. So once I'm here, basically, what he's telling me is, here is, I'm going to do a low cut or low stab. If I see his hands, it's going to be downward slash or a horizontal slash, whatever it is, yes? As long as I see it, I take it as a top attack. When I don't see his hands, I take it as something coming from below, right? So now when he's doing this, I want to see this. Now, same thing as he attacks me, that. Now, I attack him, and now he slashes, all right? So the difference is, backhand, he passes, I shield. That's one. Backhand, he passes, backhand. Or, backhand, he passes, I pass. So basically, the one above is either a shield, a backhand, or a pass. But the first two is the same. Backhand, pass, shield, backhand, pass. Backhand, pass, backhand. The reason is, take a look, because for thrust, I'm here, shield, my footwork is here. Next one, you see I'm here now? The other one, right, now this is for you. Yes? Right, so at the top, you have three options. Either the shield, pass, and backhand. But you start with the thrust, backhand, I clear it, punch, backhand, I clear it, shield, backhand, I clear it, backhand. Is that okay? Yes? No? Yes? Okay, one more time. The guy who's attacking me, make sure when you slash for my shoulder for safety reasons. Yes? If somehow you lost the sequence, at least when he misses, it's not to your face. Yes, but show the intention, because that's the important thing. So now he's at this distance. He takes a step forward. One. Yes. So now I move. You see how I'm already off balancing him on the first go? Take a look at this. Yes. He's done. So you learn how to take the techniques from the very beginning, but we have to take a sequence so that we learn how to do options of application from here, options of application from here, options of application from here. Right? So every transition of in that drill, you will learn applications from that. Make sense or not? It might look complicated now, but once you get it, you'll get it. So again, so right hand, I clear, I pass. Same movement, I shoot. Same movement, I do the back hand, and I'm done. So if I'm on the inside, yes, one, two, back. If I'm doing the pass. See, same finishing move. If I'm doing the backhand, same finishing move. Because from there, he steps back, I have this. If he doesn't step back, I have another one. So every transition, every touch he gives you, this one, every touch I give him, there will be three options of opportunities or openings. Yes?
This is a hit.
So this one, as I hit him, you see that?
And you're doing the hit here, yeah?
Yes. Sure. So I'm punching him as if I'm slashing. His defense is only the pass. So when I'm here, so as I hit him, I want to clear this. So that he gets this. Yes? So that's why you've got the three options. Inside. Outside. Or backhand.